Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. Welcome to Dart Programming Course. Cross-platform development is a very hot topic nowadays, and we have a number of options to build cross-platform applications, and Dart is one of them. In this course, we will learn the fundamentals of Dart programming, so that after this we can start learning about Flutter that can be used to build mobile, web, or desktop applications using a single code base. Now let's start with the very first question, that is, what is Dart? Dart is a client-optimized language for developing fast apps on any platform. Dart can be compiled to either native code or JavaScript, and that is why we can use it for any platform. So whatever your requirement is, it may be a mobile app, a web app, or a desktop app, there is a Dart solution. In fact, you can do server-side scripting with Dart as well. Dart is developed by Google, so you should not be in any dilemma about the future scope of the language. Dart is absolutely free and open source language. Dart is specially designed for building UIs. With Dart, you can build beautiful UIs very easily and quickly. Dart supports productive development. That means it supports the hot reload feature. To see the code changes, you do not need to rerun your application, but you will see the changes instantly in your running application. This feature makes development really fast. Dart is fast on all platforms. It compiles to native machine code for instant startup, and if you are using it for a web, it gets compiled to JavaScript. Now I think you have enough reasons to learn Dart programming language. So let's see how you can start writing Dart programs. There are two options to write and execute Dart programs. The first and the easy one is Dartpad. Just go to Google and search Dartpad, and you have Dartpad, where you can write and execute Dart programs. Unfortunately, we will not be using this method in this course. Because we seriously want to learn Dart language, we will write and execute Dart programs in our machine. And for this, we will use Dart SDK. Now let's see how we can install Dart SDK and write Dart programs. To get Dart SDK, open your browser and type dart.dev. This is the official website of Dart programming language. In this website, click on this option, that is Get Dart. And here you can see Dart is available for Windows, Linux, and Mac OS. If you are using Windows, you need to follow these steps. For Linux, you need to follow these steps. In my case, I am using MacBook, so I will follow these steps. So the first thing that I need is I need to install Homebrew. So I will open this link, and to install this thing, I need to copy this command, and then I will open terminal, and inside terminal, I will paste this command and hit enter. I need to enter my password and enter again, and it is installing Homebrew. So Homebrew is installed in my machine. Now I can install Dart. And to get Dart, first I will run this command. So let's run it. Now after this command, I will write brew install Dart. So I have brew install Dart. So now Dart is installed in my computer. And now I can write and run Dart programs. So let's see how we can run a simple hello world in Dart. You can use any editor to write Dart programs. In my case, for now, I will use Visual Studio Code. Inside Visual Studio Code, I will create a new file. You can name it anything. So I will save this file inside my desktop and I will name it main.dart. The extension is important, it should be dart. So I will save this file as main.dart. and I will write a simple hello world program. So it is very easy. We just need to write main function, and inside main I will write print hello world like this, and in dot we need to end every statement with a semicolon. So this is my main dot dot. This is a simple hello world dot program, and to run it I can go to terminal. So here I will open a new terminal, and because this file is inside desktop, first I will navigate to desktop. So here I will write cd desktop. Now here I will run the command dot and then main dot dot. And here you can see I am getting hello world. That means my program is compiled and executed successfully. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. From the next video, we will start learning the fundamentals of Dart programming language. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.